Hey guys, what's going on? So it looks like Marvel's animated Guardians of the Galaxy, their Spider-Man cartoon, and Avengers Assemble, so I guess they're finally gone. Supposedly, they're not coming back for another season, which in a lot of ways is a great thing, because a lot of the cartoons today seem to have this issue with being used as a tool for creating the argument where if you criticize a show for being portrayed in a comedic light, the excuses, and that we hear from many Marvel Animation and some people who work at DC Animation, it happens to be, oh, it's for kids. I don't believe that's true, because we were kids once. A lot of people in their 20s and 30s and 40s, we didn't have shows like this by the numbers dominating the industry and telling kids that they cannot aspire to be what their intelligence says they can be. Basically, a lot of animation talks down to children and tries to be dedicated to one specific demographic rather than be something that all ages can enjoy. Now, I don't watch a lot of animated series these days because there's nothing that inspires me to get into them. Like Teen Titans Go, it's trash. It's garbage compared to the original Teen Titans, which really taught kids that they could do anything despite how they're born, what they look like. There were a lot of themes involving racism. Spectacular Spider-Man covers drug overdose, drug usage, covers gambling, a lot of teenage rebellion. Wolverine and the X-Men covered a lot of oppression-based topics, stuff that you could find in the original Stan Lee comics. Earth's Mightiest Heroes, those were characters that a lot of people could aspire to be, even if they don't have superpowers. They could still be special in some ways. And there was a lot of life, there was a lot of love brought into these cartoons. Now we get Avengers Assemble and Spider-Man, Ultimate Spider-Man. I know that show's been done, but it shows you of how far Marvel Animation has fallen compared to their previous series. And I know Spectacular Spider-Man was a Sony thing. It was a Sony IP. Sony Pictures Animation, something like that, created the series. And I'm going to try not to ramble on for too long. I'm just going to say what's on my mind. I think that hopefully, and there are some bad points to this. I mean, nobody loves it when a bunch of people just working their jobs, you know, get the pink slips, being told that they're not needed anymore because their studio is shutting down. That's the only drawback I see when it comes to people like the staff that worked on these shows. Personally, I think this could be a great thing because Star Wars Rebels exists in a time when Disney owns the Star Wars franchise. And I keep thinking to myself, why don't we get a cartoon that has quality control, that basically has a lot of oversight from the people who know best about the source material? And to be honest, I had a lot of hopes for Marvel's Spider-Man. I thought we were finally going to get something that wasn't monkey sounds and I don't know, Family Guy cutaways and terrible acting and terrible ideas all around. Well, okay, not all the acting is terrible. I think there's some of the best actors in this in Ultimate Spider-Man. It's just that the stuff they're given, the material they work with is terrible, and it sort of brings down their performances in a way. I think that if there was a show like with Spider-Man, if there was a cartoon, an animated series that was on par with that of the 90s show, that's something a lot of people could appreciate. Or Spectacular Spider-Man. I'm a fan of both, but to be a little more, I guess, objective, I don't know if I like that word usage in this discussion. Spectacular Spider-Man does hold up more than the 90s animated series, even though select episodes of the 90s animated series hold up in presentation better than Spectacular Spider-Man does. Spectacular Spider-Man is a pretty cool cartoon, and it has long story arcs, which is one of my favorite types of storytelling in a given medium. It basically, the show itself, I think it's pretty good. I just wish the character designs weren't off. Like, the character designs are, yeah, they're not that well built. The animation kind of makes up for it, though, but is it a little bit hard to ask for both? Like, where we can get a great art style, like Ultimate Spider-Man, but great writing by Greg Wiseman in Spectacular? Because that dude, I've met that dude. I have met Greg Wiseman. He went to a convention in my local area once, and oddly enough, Dan Slott was there with him. And let me tell you something that Greg Wiseman didn't just say to me. He said to a lot of people. He wanted to continue Spectacular Spider-Man in comic book form, knowing that the show was going to be canceled. He offered to finish whatever plot lines he created, but the studio said no. Sony said no because Marvel had been facing five different lawsuits in terms of pursuing the animation rights to Spider-Man. Okay, but putting that aside, I think that if we got a cartoon that was on par with Spectacular, it doesn't have to be Spectacular itself. We could get a new show that builds up the characters based on the comic book feeling. And one of the problems with these different cartoons, I would call them Bruce Timm rip-offs, but no, they're not even worthy to be praised. Whereas Batman the Animated Series, Superman the Animated Series, Justice League, those deserve praise. I mean, this Marvel set of shows could have been the equivalent of the DC animated universe, but they didn't want to do that. And I guess, I don't know if ratings played into this, with the shows getting canceled. But I'm happy that Marvel maybe gets to start with a clean slate and just focus on what makes their source material the some of the most, how do I say this, dominant in many of their industries. They've got great movies, even though they're not perfect. I mean, they could fix the animation. And before now, they had Wolverine versus Hulk. They had Wolverine versus, no, Hulk versus Thor. They had Thor Tales of Asgard. They had Ultimate Avengers 1, Ultimate Avengers 2, The Invincible Iron Man, Doctor Strange, Sorcerer Supreme. I know I'm stuttering a little bit. It's just that I'm thinking really quick on my feet right now with all these different ideas, and all these different animated movies I've seen. I was hoping that we would get cartoons and animated films based on that quality. And I'm not saying it has to be rated R, there has to be a lot of blood and sex everywhere. No. I'm saying that one of the biggest mistakes Marvel Animation made was creating a show that was tailored toward an isolated demographic rather than create a work that all ages could appreciate. I mean, a lot of kids could probably appreciate the 90s cartoon. Others could appreciate not just Spectacular, but Wolverine and the X-Men. Cartoons that hold up in quality to today. And I think it's a problem when Marvel makes the excuses where, oh, it's just for kids. And I think it really hurts their cause because children are not as stupid as some of those people would like to think. If anything, children, they can show you a lot of great things that you wouldn't expect for someone of their age. I mean, yeah. So I think that with what's going on, our generation could inspire younger generations to sort of pay attention to what they see on TV, and they might find it relatable with things they're going through in life. Maybe there's a lot of bullying going on at school, and they feel like they could relate to, I don't know, Starfire from Teen Titans during that one episode where an alien race criticized her race by calling her something that a word that the Tamaranian race takes offense to. Tronky, I forget. It's been a while since I've seen that. But yeah, but shows like this hold up because they're such great metaphors for what real humans actually go through. And I want to see that. I don't care about the Inhumans being the X-Men. I don't care about Spider-Man focusing, Marvel Spider-Man emphasizing science a lot. I'm just not that interested. The voices are so annoying. There's nothing to take away from the show. There's no life lesson. There's no, like, it feels more like a business than an art. To such an extent where this is obviously a cash-in toward the movies. And, like, if art is not allowed to thrive, then why are you in this business, is what I'm wondering. I think business sells really well, and maybe, who knows, maybe I could ask people who've worked in business, this type of business, where a presentation manages to bolster demand, where people love it. And The problem is, as well, is that we have all these network execs on Cartoon Network and Nickelodeon determining what kids love rather than, I don't know, consulting with a child psychologist or talking to families and parents and things like that. Like, I don't have a kid right now, but if I ever did, I would want them to watch a lot of great content that I got to experience. I would like to pass down the sort of traditions that I got to look at firsthand in the Marvel Universe. I mean, Marvel never has this problem with some of their storytelling in video games. Movies, they seem to tell great stories, though, you know, Iron Man 3 wasn't that wild. It was wild for all the wrong reasons. Captain America the Winter Soldier. It's like, these shows, Avengers Assemble and Guardians, they're so lifeless. I just don't give a shit. No, like, anyone who's got a great, I don't know, more than a short attention span, they're obviously going to turn away from things like this. And I think that's really sad. I think it's a terrible shame. I think kids deserve better. And their parents do too. Their brothers and sisters. I think instead of focusing on one demographic, the shows themselves should be aimed at everybody. I mean, we had this before. And it's not just Marvel. DC has Young Justice coming back for season 3. And I'm not just talking about how terrible I think that the new Marvel shows are. I'm talking about the merits of bringing back a work, an art, that people could take seriously. DC has Young Justice, they have their animated movies, some are hit and miss, but there are a lot of memorable ones out there for everybody, even though everybody has different opinions. And I guess I haven't been talking enough about the actual article I found. It's a CBR article. I know those people tend to do clickbait, but these are real quotes coming from crew members of the show. Saying that some Marvel animation shows are going on hiatus and we're told crews are being laid off. Let's see what else here. So yeah, many artists at the studio will be gone. The series have not been renewed. Things are up in the air. And you know what? Let's shift the focus for a second. I don't want to talk about how bad I think something already is or whatever in that area. I want to talk about things I'd like to see. I'd like to see Spider-Man be his own character on his own terms instead of depending on Iron Man. I want to see him face Venom, Carnage, the Sinister Six, the Goblins. I want to see him in his own world. Like, do it like a season 1 type of thing where you get to know every character and you have Spider-Man being the only spider. Season 2, season 3, they build up some of the other villains like Tombstone, maybe some B-list characters, C-list characters like Hydro-Man. Season 4, shit gets real, where I guess characters from the Marvel Universe help Spider-Man out, and Season 5, Spider-Man travels the multiverse. And I know, this sounds like the form of storytelling with the 90s cartoon. I think the format is really good there. I just, you know, I want to see it modernized, get modern costumes, or who knows, maybe go all that way back in the 60s, but sort of modernize the 60s and then do the comic book depictions of today. I've been speaking a lot for the past 14 minutes. So yeah, I'm a big Spider-Man fan. But the thing is, Marvel has more characters and they should make them just as interesting in their animation studio as they do in their movie division. Personally, I'd like to see an older Spider-Man, someone who's 20, like a Spider-Man who's 20, 25. I'm tired of Spider-Teen. I don't get the obsession with making Spider-Man a teenager when he was like that briefly in the 60s, and he's been an adult most of his superhero life, most of his human identity, unmasked life. I just don't understand. Anyway, I'm going to close out the discussion and get everybody's opinions. I mean, I just want to hear from you. I'll probably respond to some comments. I can't respond to every comment, but I can certainly answer a few questions. Maybe we can start a discussion. I don't mind. I mean, somebody wants to write a comment, I'll answer back if they have any questions or anything to say, or they want to get more of my 2 cents on this matter than what I've already talked about. Okay, cool. See you guys later.